Hello again, everyone. If you recall the last time I was here, we took you on a tour of some of the sculptures you could see on your next visit. That story was so well received, we thought we'd show you some more sculptures on the Purdue campus. One of the easiest structures to find is Purdue's bell tower. It was built with donations from the class of 1948. The bells that now hang in a cluster in the center of the tower are the original bells that hung in the old Heveland Hall before it was destroyed in a fire. The structure is 163 feet tall, made from steel and brick. The clock face on the bell tower uses four eyes instead of the Roman numerals IV to indicate four. The four eyes visually balances better with the Roman numeral 8 that is directly opposite it on the clock's face. The site development around the bell tower is known as the Special Places Garden. It was completed in 2000, funded by the class of 1949. This life-size bronze sculpture, entitled Continuum, is a depiction of the enduring relationship between humans and animals. It was paid for by private gifts and dedicated in September of 2000. Continuum features seven distinct pieces, including a variety of life-size animals and humans. It was designed by Larry Anderson, who created the sculpture in his studio near Seattle, Washington, over an 18-month period. Continuum is approximately 45 feet long and at its highest point, 9 feet. Another of the iconic structures on campus is the Purdue Mall Fountain, also known as the Engineering Fountain. The class of 1939 donated $350,000 to build this fountain in observance of its 50th anniversary. The water sculpture was designed by artist Robert Youngman. Van Phillips, a Purdue professor of theater, designed the lighting system. The structure is 60 feet in diameter and 38 feet high. It includes 280 lights and 228 tons of concrete. When operational, 36 nozzles drive as much as 588 gallons of recycled water per minute. One of the most notable alumnus of Purdue University is Neil Armstrong, the first person to walk on the moon. An 8-foot bronze sculpture of Armstrong sits in front of the building bearing his name and depicts Armstrong as an undergraduate student in the 1950s. This sculpture, created by artist Chaz Fagan, shows Armstrong sitting on a stone plinth and wearing a windbreaker, Oxford shirt, khaki pants, and penny loafers. Armstrong, the first person to land on the moon, is gazing over his left shoulder at a trail of sculpted moon boot impressions and other symbolic features. An elliptical stone arc resembling a spacecraft trajectory sits next to the sculpture with the inscription, "One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind." The arc leads toward lunar footprints that replicate the bounding gait of an Apollo astronaut. And then there is the Boilermaker. Legend has it that in 1889, two football coaches enrolled several Husky Boilermakers from the Monon Railroad. These men set out to play football and won game after game. Incensed Crawfordsville newspaper writers wrote uncomplimentary stories calling the team sluggers, cornfield sailors, haymakers, and Boilermakers. The last name struck the fancy of Purdue students and has been the nickname ever since. Sculptor John Hare of Cornelius, North Carolina, began work on the statue in 2003 on behalf of an anonymous donor who wanted to present Purdue with a statue of the world's largest Boilermaker. As you can see, there's a wide variety of artwork all over campus for you to enjoy. If you want more information on the artwork, you can visit Purdue University's Visitor Information Center. They'll be happy to help you. For Boiler Bytes, I'm Kyle Cray.